and NBC5 News. Guess what? You're watching The Philippe Matthews Show, number one.
Welcome to the Philippe Matthews Show at thepmshow.tv. Named the Oprah of the Internet by Mark Victor Hansen, Philippe Matthews doesn't ask questions that are different. He simply asks questions that make a difference. The Philippe Matthews Show features entertainers, bestsellers, authors, thought leaders, change agents, and world-class experts in the field of personal, spiritual, and professional development. An internet marketing entrepreneur, Philippe is the creator of the How Movement, dedicated to teaching people how to move from the mindset of hope to the process of how. If you are ready to take your life to the next level, move from the mindset of why to the mindset of why not. Tune in right now to this latest edition of the Philippe Matthews Show and watch your life grow.
Hey, we're back, ladies and gentlemen, on the Philippe Matthews Show. I am so stoked. I am so hyped. I have got one of the most beautiful women in the world on the phone with me today. Her name is Rosie Mercado. She's a celebrity makeup artist, actress, radio personality, host, community philanthropist, and she's a mother of three, and she's the star of the reality show Curvy Girls, and she's one of the most brilliant women I have ever met, and I'm excited that you're on the show with me today. How are you doing, Rosie?
I am so great. Thank you so much for having me on the show and giving me the opportunity to be able to talk to your listeners. I'm just astonished by all the things that you've created and done and really pushing it forward to getting the information to really motivate and empower people with some great stuff. I am such a fan of your last interview that you did with Dr. Wayne Dyer, and I was just so excited to be able to listen and just to connect with people that are doing some amazing things. So congratulations to you as well.
Well, thank you, my dear. And you're doing some wonderfully great things, too. I mean, you have taken full-figure modeling, plus-size modeling to a completely different level and are not only helping women feel good about themselves, but also helping young women and girls, teen girls and little girls feel great about themselves and the possibility of being able to be a model and to be attractive and to feel wonderful and empowered in their body, in their skin.
Thank you. Well, you know what? For me, it was important growing up. I didn't have that availability to me, and always having that passion and that drive and just wanting to be part of the entertainment industry, not being accepted just because of my size and rejected because of my size, because I was always told that I had the talent, but I didn't have the size, that if I was good from the waist up and from the waist down, I had to keep losing weight if I ever wanted to make it in this industry. And it goes to show that when you're persistent, you're driven, and you have a strategy, and you really are passionate about what you do, you can make anything come to pass if you really believe in it. And it takes action and a great strategy, and also great people around you supporting your vision and your dreams to be able to pursue it and accomplish that. So I'm just really blessed that I'm on this great journey. I've learned so much about what my capabilities are, what I could do, and also I've had the opportunity to show people that when you dream and you persevere, anything is possible. And, you know, one of the favorite things that Dr. Wayne Dyer, you know, he quotes is saying that, you know, a thought, you know, a dream started, you know, an action, or I should say, when you look at something, it started as a dream, as a thought, as an imagination, and then it became reality. Mm-hmm. And that's something that I can attest that is so true. I would never think that being a size 32 model going into the industry, I was going to get accepted, but I went with it because I wanted to be able not to only go about my dreams, but represent those women that weren't represented like myself, that I'm going to look at clothes and say, okay, that's how I really look, and I should look good at that size, and if I want to drop weight, I should also look good at that size, and just empower women to take that initiative and saying, hold on, why am I sitting behind closed doors? Why am I not enjoying life? Why am I not seizing the moment? You're only guaranteed today, so you got to make it fantastic.
Absolutely. Now, where are you from, my dear?
I am actually from California. And when I was younger, I moved down to Las Vegas with my family. So we were living over there near Riverside. And my parents had a company. They decided to bring it to Las Vegas. And we moved, and kind of just Vegas grew on me. I was raised out in Vegas.
Okay, what was your childhood like? You have brothers and sisters?
Yes, I have two sisters, two beautiful sisters, and I have a brother. I am the oldest of them all, and two great parents. I am I'm Latina. I'm proud to be Latina. My parents are from Mexico. Great family. They're very supportive, very very driven in the business world, and I just have a great set of parents that really believe in me. I've learned so much along the way, and I've accomplished things. I've fell down. I've gotten back up. But it's been a wonderful journey and a great experience that I've learned from.
So when you were a child, when did you, or not even a child, I guess the question is, when did you realize that you wanted to be a model, could be a model? What was that awakening like for you?
I think the awakening really came in when I was when I was in high school. I think that's when it really dawned on me that I was interested in modeling, and then just kind of sitting in the corner, and especially career days when they had model interviews. They had people could come in for career days. I remember that in high school. They come in and they're like, well, you know what, you would be good for this. And I remember my friends all getting told, well, you could model. You have the perfect model body for modeling. And they're like, well, you have a beautiful face. And they believe that. And I'm like, well, I'm interested in modeling too. And I never had that opportunity to kind of pursue it. It was just something that was always in the back of my head. And during high school, I was lucky enough that I got to work on a radio station in the morning as a morning host and kind of learned that. And I kind of fell into entertainment. And it was a wonderful experience because I really felt passionate about just putting my voice out there and being out there and doing celebrity interviews. And just one thing led to another. But it was really in high school and everything dawned on me that there was no real plus size actresses that I could really look up to, that I could say, okay, they're Latina and I could relate to them, or they have my body type, or I want to be like them. You know, Jennifer Lopez, you know, was someone who had an incredible body. She's curvy, but she wasn't plus size. And I thought she was beautiful, and I was like, okay, we need some more representation. So that's when it dawned on me that I was like, I really want to do this, but how am I going to start, or who's going to believe in me, or who's going to give me the opportunity? And that led me into makeup artistry, and one thing led to another. And it's funny how I fell into the industry, because through my makeup artistry as well, I didn't have the budget to acquire models, so I decided to take pictures of myself. And people started getting a hold of my pictures, and they're like, wow, you know, who is this girl? And I started getting contact from agencies, and then show up, and they're like, oh, well, you are stunningly beautiful, but you have to lose weight. We never thought that you were that size. And when I started getting that response, it started kind of creating this anger and drive at the same time. And I'm like, hold on. If there's 67% of women in the U.S. are plus size, you know, where are we being represented? Why can't I do this? Why am I being rejected? I don't agree with that. And that just created a drive to keep on going. And I didn't know what I was doing, just knocking on doors, networking, and putting out my thoughts and my views and my passions. And people started believing in everything that I was doing, and that's been part of my success.
Well, you had a big break in 2009. You entered the Miss Plus America pageant and was crowned Miss Nevada Plus America, and so you won. Is that right?
Yes, I was. Well, it was wonderful because I got invited to be part of Miss Plus America, and I did the state. The state pageant won that, which was wonderful. It was great because I was like, oh, my God, I'm a beauty queen. Someone celebrates my size. It's okay to be this size and say, I'm a beauty queen, and have a crown and sash and be able to do work and really go out there and inspire all these plus-size women. It didn't even know that Miss Plus America existed. And through that, I went into the nationals. I went to nationals, which was wonderful, and I had the opportunity to talk, you know, fortunately for me, the year that Nationals was going on that I participated, Taboo, National Geographic was there, and they got to film my entire experience and the other women, and they really showcased, you know, kind of what I went through in that documentary, which was a wonderful opportunity because that created more open doors for me.
I was going to talk about that. National Geographic, that's no joke, man. That's top of the line. That's world class. Wow.
Yeah, you know what they did? Well, the episode was you know, they had the good and the bad, of course, like anything else. You got to get both sides of the story. But, you know, they really showcase that as a woman, you know, you have to take control of your destiny. You really have to take control of what your passion is and what drives you. And you have to be okay with that even if nobody else is, even if nobody else believes in you. You have to say, okay, this is what I want. I'm going to go for it. Regardless if people believe it or not, I believe in it, and that's enough. Let me go for it, and let me see how many doors I can knock down. Let me see how many people I can inspire and how many people I can get to run and say, hold on. there's something there. And National Geographic gave me that opportunity. And, of course, I won at Miss South America. I became Cover Girl of the Year, Miss Photogenic, People's Choice. I came home with so many awards. And more than anything, the experience of being around powerful, beautiful, plus-size women that were going not just for the crown, but to be able to leave a message behind, leave a legacy of beauty and empowerment behind, and also transform women's lives. I mean, that was just like, I was like, oh, my God, where did all these beautiful plus-size women? This is what I've been waiting for my entire life. And that was a wonderful experience. And thankfully, National Geographic was there, and I got to be a part of that, and they got to showcase it. And it's gone around internationally around the world. I always know when it's playing. It's still playing until now. And it's wonderful to get the feedback of females, of women from different places in the world, from Spain to London to Africa, just different places in the world saying, my God, I never knew this existed. And because I saw you, I feel inspired to create something with my life. And I said, you know what? That is a blessing. I served my purpose right there.
That's incredible. Now, you, as a result of this, you're really what I consider to be an empire unto yourself. So I don't know if you have launched it or you're working on launching your own clothing line, your own makeup line. Talk to us about that.
Well, I do have my own cosmetic line. It's called Miss Felicima. I'm currently rebranding everything. It's a cosmetic line that's based on natural minerals. And I'm a girl that's always been in love with being girly and being elegant and being classy and getting dolled up. And through my makeup artist, I just found that, you know, there was a lot of things that were needed, and I decided to create them and kind of give that to my customer, give that back, make sure that as I was doing the makeup application, I was putting something that was going to benefit their skin, was going to help them look radiant, and really, you know, through makeup technique, just really make their best beauty shine forward. And it's MissFelicima.com. You can go to Shop Rosie Mercado and take a look at the products that I have so far. But it's going through rebranding. And, yes, I'm excited. I have been a designer at heart always. Being plus size, and I think a lot of the women that are in the plus size industry will relate to this. Growing up, I did not have that fashion-forward statement piece that I wanted to have. But I didn't have the clothing that I wanted to represent my personality. And that was a real frustration for me because I'd go to stores, and I'd look at clothes, and I'm like, oh, my God, I'm supposed to wear that. And I never represented my age. I always looked older because the clothes were never fitting. They never showed my body in the right light. And I just had that frustration. I would see all these beautiful girls at high school wearing these beautiful pieces, and I'm like, I want to dress like that. Why can't I dress like that? Just because I'm bigger. So I had the opportunity. You know, my mom always said, you know, you could do it. You could, you know, create something or look at something and recreate it and make it your own. You make your personality shine. You show people that you could do it. So I worked at the seamstress growing up and creating my own pieces and buying fabrics, and that really gives me a push to where I'm at now because, you know, throughout the years, even being, now that I've lost 90 pounds.
Oh,
and
fantastic.
Even at a bigger size, thank you. Being a bigger size, I still didn't have that representation of who I wanted to be, and I've always considered my personality to be very classy, and I love dresses, and I'm very inspired by 1940s, 1950s clothing. So, you know, a lot of the inspirations came from that. So I have the opportunity now, as I've gotten so many open doors and so many blessings come my way, to finally work after a company that I was so persistently after, knocking on that door. Finally, they gave me a call and said, you know, we want to work with you, but we have this in mind, not so much just on modeling. We have, you know, a bigger opportunity. What do you think? And we're collaborating on the three-piece collection that's going to launch this season coming up, the holiday season. And it's a little bit of what makes me feel beautiful, and I have the opportunity to share it with other plus-size women that want to feel beautiful and want to dress up in dresses and want to just showcase who they are, and they're not afraid to say, you know what, I'm a plus-size woman, and I'm driven, and I'm powerful, and I deserve fashion. And it's just
Absolutely.
Setting women up to dress for success and love themselves. And you can check that out through SwackDesigns.com, which is the company that I'm collaborating with, and it's been an incredible journey.
Fantastic. You know, I found out about you through surfing on Facebook, and there was something on there, I think it was a fan page of beautiful women or something like that, and then I saw you, and I said, wow, she is stunning, and I looked further and said, oh, my gosh, she is on the reality show Curvy Girls. Talk to me about Curvy Girls. How did that come about? How long has the show been running? I think it's a fantastic show. You seem to be the motivator and the inspirational go-to girl to pull everybody together and you know, give everybody the pep talk. Talk to me about Curvy Girls and how that came about for you.
Well, Curvy Girls came about, actually, Curvy Girls has been such a work in progress. When I first started about 3 years ago in this industry, I started off and my fingers got out because of my makeup artist, as I had told you. And some beautiful ladies named Lisa and Laura Foreman, they found my pictures and they contacted me via MySpace. And that was, I mean, that was 3 years ago. And they said, we want to set something up. We want to talk to you. We love what you're doing. We love what you represent. Would you come, you know, come in and, you know, can we do an interview? We have this going on. We're casting for the show. And as soon as I got there, we totally hit it up. They loved my journey. They loved my story. And they loved everything that I was doing. And they said, we want you to be part of this. This was 3 years, 3-4 years ago that we did this. Now, this isn't a work in progress. It was not overnight. And finally, about a year ago, they called me up and said, you know what? The show's been picked up, and you are part of the team. And we want to showcase your story and your struggles and the reality of what you've gone through at your size. And I said, this is an opportunity, and those opportunities, you got to seize them. You got to take them as they come. And, you know, thankfully, Nuvo TV picked it up. They believe in what we're doing. They believe in getting the word out there. And, you know, when I was going into the show, my biggest thing is I have to remain true to my values, true to who I am. I have ups and downs. I'm a human being. There's days that are wonderful, and, you know, I'm grateful. And there's days that are tough, and I'm grateful, too. But I have the opportunity to showcase women that my career has not been overnight. It's taken work, dedication, persistence, perseverance, faith, in what I'm doing to be able to accomplish everything, and more than anything, great family support and determination to keep going. Because those days that, you know, you're doing your work, you're booking jobs, and, you know, there's you know, but those are wonderful days. But the day that you get that no, or you really have your hopes on getting, you know, a certain position, and you know you didn't quite accomplish it yet. It's all about divine order.
I remember watching one of the episodes, and you were hoping that you were going to get this cover, and you remember that, and you didn't.
I remember that.
That was real.
That was real. No, I really wanted. They were looking for Latina representation plus size, and I said, you know, what better way to break the, you know, change the views of beauty than put in a girl that's a size 28. Then I was a size 28, 30 on the bottom. And I said, you know, I'm here. Give me the opportunity. And trust me, I will work hard and I will represent and I want to inspire and I want to showcase something completely different. And this is the opportunity. You know, I hope you choose me. And unfortunately, they didn't feel strong enough. They were, you know, they really held back because of my size. They said I had everything going but my size. And that really was, you know, that was a breaking moment for me because, you know, it's not just about me accomplishing that goal. I just think about all those women that are my size and looking at that and saying, wow, you know, there goes another rejection, you know. Or, you know, going into this thought process because I have so many emails of people that wrote to me and they're like, we wish you would have been on there. And, you know, that's why I'm afraid to follow my dreams because what if I get rejected? The reality is there's going to be no's. There's going to be no's in life. Not everything is sweet and candy. It really isn't. You know, there's going to be no's. And I think those no's are there. They're there to see how much you want something, how much drive you're willing to go forward and keep on going and be persistent on your dreams. So that was a benchmark. That was like a stepping stone for me to say, okay, what do I have to do to get where I want? What strategy am I going to do? And is this going to break me and say, this is it? I'm letting go of the industry. I'm letting go of my career. I'm letting go of my dreams, and I'm letting it all go because I got one no. And no, that was a stepping stone for me to say, nope. I'm holding on tighter than ever, and if this wasn't for me, then something else will be. God has everything in divine order, and now it's time to re-strategize, refocus, and think of what my next goal is and how am I going to impact the industry, how am I going to change the views of beauty, and how am I going to keep inspiring women to understand that even if you get a no, you have to keep on going.
Incredible, incredible. So Curvy Girls is on Nuvo TV. What is the web address for that?
Yeah, it's mindnuvotv.com. They can check out Curvy Girls. There's new episodes every Tuesday at 8 o'clock at night. And, you know, check out Curvy Girls. It's 4 plus-size models, me being one of them. You get to see different journeys. And I'm just blessed that I'm just me. What you see is what you get. I'm just really putting myself out there, and you get to see my ups, my downs. You get to see dating. You get to see me as a single mom. I'm a single mom and balancing career. And for all those single moms that are listening, I know it's not tough, but you know what? It's so worth it because my kids are growing up, seeing their mom, you know, working on my passions, and they're seeing a mom that's fighting for her dreams and is not giving up. And I want my kids always to grow up with that. I've always said that, you know, wherever my kids decide to go, whatever dreams they decide, you know, to go after, I'm always going to be supportive. But I want them always to remember that even though I went through the divorce and even though I'm a single mom, I want them always to remember that their mom never gave up. And I decided to be a victor instead of a victim. And I did not let that, you know, my past determine my destiny.
Absolutely. Now, tell me about your kids. Do they have any aspirations? How old are they? Do they have any aspirations following mommy's footsteps?
Well, you know what? I think my son is 4, and I have my he's gonna be 5 this month, and then I have my 6-year-old. So I have Alex and Valentino, and then I have Isabella. Trying to get all my kids straight, and Isabella's 12, and my daughter is actually, she's a working artist. She loves art. She's very inspired by art. She's very creative, and I think she's going to follow the designing path. She loves jewelry and clothing, and she's doing some great things with that, so you know, I'm very proud of her with everything that she's doing. I think my young one, I think he's gonna be able to model and go into dancing and do different things because, I mean, the music goes on. He loves to be the center of the stage. He loves to dance. He loves to sing. He likes to get out there, and my other son is very musical as well. He loves music, anything that's involved with music. So I don't know what their passions will be as they grow up. You know, things change, but whatever they are, I'm just, you know, I'm blessed to have my kids. They're a great motivation in my life, and I just want to make sure that I serve as an inspiration for them to keep going, and that as they're growing, we're creating these memories that they always will remember that. In the toughest moments, I never gave up, and I always fought for them, and I always fought for my dreams, and that they always remember that they cannot afford to give up. The life is too beautiful.
Absolutely. What is it like working with the other reality show cast members?
What is it like? Well, you know, you're dealing with people. We're all human. We're not perfect. I have some great friendships established with some of the girls, and beautiful spirits. They have their ups and their downs. We're all in the same career. It's competitive. Sometimes we have the same casting. It's been a wonderful experience to see their growth as well, as not only as models, but as women. I relate a lot with Denise, which is one of the models. She's a single mom, and we go through a lot of the same things, and I have a great friendship established with her. I love her dearly, and I'm just so proud of her accomplishments. And also with Lorna, you know, we've gotten so much closer and just really built this friendship where, you know, we can go back and forth. We can be very honest with each other, very raw, and there's no feelings hurt. So, I mean, there's some great friendships that have been established. With Ivory has her own personality. You know, I still respect her, and she's got her own personality going on. I don't agree with a lot of stuff that she does. But, you know, we have to learn how to deal with people from day to day and, you know, love them and not judge them for who they are. Just love them, and you accept who they are, and you kind of move forward. And if you disagree with something, you just disagree, and you got to keep moving forward.
Sure.
So at the end of the day, we're human beings. We're not perfect. We have our ups and downs, but you just got to keep on moving.
Talk to me about your philanthropic work. I know you do a lot of fundraising work, and talk to us about some of those projects that you're working on.
Some of the great projects that I've worked on, you know, and that I'm working on is that I've had the opportunity, like right now I have, I'm Christian. I'm a woman of faith. I'm a woman of faith, and I have the opportunity to work with the youth group here in Las Vegas. It's called United, and I get to work with the girls. I you know, one of my cousins is makeup artistry, and I get to showcase, you know, showcase them the importance of dressing for success, of taking care of yourself, and you know, how everything just turns around. So I get to work with the youth and these girls and teach them how to sell themselves up and build their self-esteem and empower them and give them techniques on how to have confidence, because I just feel that confidence is really lacking in some of our youth today. And it's because of social media. It's because of things that they see. And because of low self-esteem, you end up making these decisions that aren't the best decisions for your future life. So with that said, I have a great opportunity of working with them and just spending quality time with these girls and kind of just seeing where they're at and teaching them about makeup and empowerment and success and drive and the importance of the combination of everything to be able to fulfill their life purpose and, you know, figuring out what their life purpose is, because it's good to be able to ask those questions at a young age and know where you're going. But like that, you try to stay as close as on a straight road as possible, and you got to be clear on what you want. And, you know, I have that privilege of being able to talk to them and figure out where they're at and being a part of their journey, being a witness to their journey. And that, I think, is a blessing, because at the end of the day, what you contribute, what you give out is what you get back. And I have my kids, and I want to make sure that if it's 1% at a time that I'm able to inspire and be a blessing to, those blessings will come back, not so much to me, but to my kids. And what mother doesn't want to see their kids happy in the future?
Absolutely. I have to ask you this question. I remember when we were talking, I forgot what call it was. It was in the evening when I was having cigar and scotch with my buddies. And I was telling them I was getting ready to interview Rosie Mercado, and they knew of you, and I showed them the photo, and they said, "Oh, my God, you got to give me a phone number." So I got to ask, what is your idea? Are you in love? Are you looking for a relationship, and what is your ideal man?
Oh, my God, am I in love? I am in love with love. I am a hopeless romantic, if you want to say that. I am in love with love. Anything that's love, I love. Oh, my God, we could talk about love all day. I am single. I'm very driven by my career, and I'm finding balance between my career, spirituality, and my kids. And, yes, I miss having a good man at my side. I've been divorced for about five, 6 years now, and I'm just, you know, I don't want to say that I'm looking for, because every time you look for, I want to say I'm attracting. I'm attracting a man that is a visionary and that is passionate about life and is driven and has values. Values for me are everything. I think just really family-oriented and has a life of his own, and also contribution is big for me, because, you know, a man that has a heart of contribution has a heart of gold, you know, and he's compassionate about other people. It's so amazing to find. It's rare to find that, but it's amazing to find when you do find those kind of people. How attracted that, I don't know, I'm very attracted to that inner gentleman. I love gentlemen. I want my door to be open. I love flowers. I don't know. I want to take things slow. So I'm going to try to talk with driven, passionate gentlemen into my life, and, you know, when it happens, I'm ready to commit and give 100% into the relationship and just love.
So are you open to marriage again?
I am open to marriage, not right now, but in the future I am. I am open to marriage. When it'll happen, it'll happen. You know, it's just finding the right person and understanding that my kids are a huge part of my life. Just finding that person that's understanding that there's balance and that I have kids and I have a career and is willing to love me and my family.
I will put an ad on Craigslist for you. How's that?
Oh, no, not on Craigslist. Oh, no. Please don't love me that much. Uh-oh.
So my last question to you is that there's going to be a lot of young girls listening to this call and a lot of women listening to this call. What advice would you give them that they have an aspiration of getting into the plus-size modeling industry? What advice would you give them?
What I would give them, I get emails, and this is funny, I get emails so from around the world via Facebook or my website, rosiemercado.com, and it's always these women asking me, "Rosie, do you think, will you please take time and look at my pictures? Do you think I have the potential?" And my biggest thing, I'm never going to tell anybody that they don't have the potential, because I always was told, you can never do it. So you're never going to hear me say, you cannot do it. Does it feel natural to you is the question you should be asking. Is this something that you really see yourself doing? Are you passionate enough? Why are you doing it? Are you doing it for fame, or are you doing it to inspire? There's so many questions that you have to ask yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You need this clarity, because at the end of the day, anything that's going to work for you, it cannot be just about you. It has to be about what you're going to do, how you're going to contribute, how you're going to impact, and at the same time, you know, you're going to benefit from it, absolutely. You know, you have to reap the benefits, absolutely. But it cannot be just about fame. And that's what I want women to understand, that this is not about being famous, and this is about inspiring, breaking barriers, changing the views of beauty. If you feel that your passion is modeling and you feel that it feels natural to you and you see it and you can envision it and you can feel it, then do it. And the best way you could do it is by taking action and having a strategy and understanding that if you're going to go into this industry, you have to have tough skin. You have to be focused. You have to be determined and not give up after the first 10 no's. If you really believe in what you're doing, you have to stay persistent and stay true to your values. You need to understand where you are at and where you're going. And you have to educate yourself. You definitely have to educate yourself all the time. What's going on in the industry? What are they looking for? You need to go knock on doors and share your passion, share your dreams with other people. And when you're passionate enough and you believe in yourself enough, things will come to pass. My biggest thing is to the girls that are listening out there, never take no for an answer. A door closed always comes from a place of gratitude. There will always be a door open. And never, never, never underestimate the power of creating relationships. In this lifetime, the importance of getting ahead in any kind of business is the importance of creating relationships wherever you stand. Always be willing to give a helping hand and not always just take, because it's not just me, 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 me. Give back, contribute, empower, make a difference, create a change. Follow your heart, follow your dreams, get a strategy, become a visionary, and dare to dream.
Wow. Wow. That is exceptionally powerful. Well, my dear, I want to ask you a favor, and that is I want you to come back on the show whenever you have anything to talk about. You could be launching some Kleenex or facial tissue. I don't care. Just come on the show and tell us about it because we absolutely love you, adore you, and support you. And everything that you are doing and about, keep me posted so I can repost it to our readers, listeners, and viewers here on the Philippe Matthews Show. But I just want to thank you for being you and showing up at this time and place and space in the world. You're much needed and much appreciated.
No, well, Philippe, thank you so much. It's wonderful to be part of your show. It's wonderful to be able to connect. And that's when it's great attracting people like yourself into my life. It's a blessing. It's wonderful that you give me the opportunity and get my message out there, which is a message of inspiration and love. And I want to make sure I leave that legacy behind always. Life is about what you create. Never give up. And thanks for letting me share that message with the wonderful women that that are listening. You are also changing many lives. You're inspirational. And it's wonderful to connect with people like you because you serve as an inspiration in my life to keep on going as well. So
thank you, darling. Love you much.
Thank you so much. I want to invite everybody for one last chance. Please watch Curvy Girls. Your support is greatly appreciated, and we need to get this message out there.
Give the web address again.
Yeah, Curvy Girls. Make sure to check it out on MyNuvoTV. You can check out for listings and showtimes, new episodes every Tuesday. And, of course, if you have any questions and you want to write and reach out to me, I am more than happy to answer all your questions. You can reach out to me at rosiemercado.com or check me out on Facebook or follow me on Twitter. Thank you so much. It's amazing what you're doing. Anything that I can contribute and help your show with, please, please, please send me everything because I want to make sure and get your voice out there as well.
I appreciate you, my dear. I love you. Thank you so much for your time. And we'll definitely be in touch, and we'll definitely do some things together.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. Keep on going.
All right, my dear. You take care.
Take care. Bye.
All right, Rosie. Bye-bye.
You know, you're watching the Philippe Matthews shows. Now, let me just give you my opinion. He is the Oprah of Internet. What that means is that he is getting together the biggest audience of people that want to make a difference in the world. And if that's you, you keep watching.